Today, the session it is something different. That's why I'm using the things different things. So as I have told you in last class, we'll be going to 1 second. Sir, can you make my video just can you pin it, sir, to screen?
हाँ
Yes, sir. Please make my video just pin that video, sir, to all, so that they can see the things
ओके
I am showing you. As we have discussed in yesterday's class, so this it is Raspberry Pi, and today actually I'm going to explain you, or not even explain, like I'll be going to show you how to make this Raspberry Pi, this board, as a complete computer, full computer actually. That we'll see today now. Okay, how this Raspberry Pi can be make as a computer, pocket size computer. So now, as I have shown you yesterday, so here, see, this is Raspberry Pi 3. This is Raspberry Pi 3 version, right? And this is Raspberry Pi 4. Raspberry Pi 4, right? And the difference between the Raspberry Pi 3 and Raspberry Pi 4 are actually Raspberry Pi 3. 2 GB RAM it is there. In Raspberry Pi 4, it is 4 GB RAM it is there. That is what the basic difference, sir. In Raspberry Pi 3, this is Raspberry Pi 3. Here, 2 GB RAM is there, right? And here, 4 GB RAM is there. And moreover, you can connect any external memory by using the slot here, SD card slot. So here in Raspberry Pi 3, I have used 32 GB. You can see over there, right? 32 GB. Okay, the 32 number, 32 GB memory card I have used here in Raspberry Pi 3. This is Raspberry Pi 3, and in Raspberry Pi 4, I have used 4 GB memory card. I'll just take it out and I'll show you. This it is 4 GB one. Yes, 4 GB. Four GB one. Okay, so you can just insert it is like this. Yeah. Right. So now even more, I'll show you some more differences here. You can see now in Raspberry Pi 4, here, as I have shown yesterday, this is Ethernet cable, Ethernet port actually. Means you can just plug your internet connection over here. And these two are USB 3. And these two ports are USB 2. So the basic difference between USB 3, USB 2, it is actually data transfer rate. Okay. So for larger data transfer rate, let's say if you want to connect your what is that, pen drive or something like that, you can use these two. Pen drive or hard disk, external hard disk, you can use these two. If you want to connect something like a keyboard and a mouse, you can use these two, right? Where the data transfer rate can be very less actually. But when you use some external hard disk or what I say, the USB pen drive, then you have to connect here so that larger data transfer can be expected. Okay, then you can see over here, these two ports are HDMI. This one, these two are HDMI ports actually. And these HDMIs are micro HDMIs, things it is needed over here. and this one it is power jack, 3.5 mm power jack. Okay, sorry, not power jack. What is it? Sound jack. So audio jack actually, right? 3.5 mm audio jack. And here type C charge. You can connect type C charger here, like type C power cable actually. Type C power cable. I'll show you that what is actually how it is there. Okay. Then next from here, you know already the memory. It can be memory card. Actually, you have to insert it. But some people you might be getting doubt that sir, why we need to keep it? Suppose if I don't want to come keep the external memory card, then what it can happen? The thing it is that I won't be having some extra memory. What you are saying that some 4 GB RAM it is already there on this one. So I'm not if I am not going to use this 4 GB memory card, then the actually thing it is I may not be having extra memory, but it is not like that. If you don't use this 4 GB memory card, then you are not actually you cannot run any OS over here. And when there is no OS is running on this, then there is no use of this board actually. Got it or not? So that's why actually what we do, we just copy the OS operating system files in this memory card from computer. And after that, we need to just insert here and just connect keyboard, mouse from these ports, keyboard and mouse. Then just connect through HDMI, connect any display, then connect the power jack and power charge power connection here. Then just start the board. It will be like initiating the booting process, means installing the OS installation process. It will start, right? So actually, we need to copy the OS here first, and we copy co just insert this into computer and get copy the OS in this one. Then just start the booting process. Okay, so but. RAM here it is like volatile memory. Okay, so basically when you just power off all entire RAM, it will be like erased. Okay, so this is the Raspberry Pi 4, and same number of here we already know the these pins are general purpose input output. So you can connect some sensors over here, right? Okay, those kind of thing can be connected over here. And second thing it is that, and if you come to Raspberry Pi 3, in Raspberry Pi 3, see here, same this it is there, Ethernet port, then all four are USB 2 only. There is no USB 3 like this. There is no USB 3 like Raspberry Pi 4. Here all are USB 2 only. And second thing it is that there actually two HDMIs are there, number one, number two. But here only one HDMI, and this it is normal HDMI. But here there are micro HDMIs. The difference it is that you can connect two monitors over here. You can simultaneously connect two monitors over here, but here only one monitor can be connected, right? And here the charging capability is different now, right? It is not like this. It is different, okay? Just like your mobile phone. Power cable. Okay, and here I have you. I'm using this one now. I'm using this one. That's why I kept 32 GB memory card over here, because to install the things, to install the operating system. Okay, so why I have used? Because of the HDMI cable. Why? Because I'm not available. I mean, with me, these micro HDMI is not available with me. That's why these micro HDMIs are not available with me. That's why just I have taken this general HDMI cable. Generally, what we have see everywhere we see that normal HDMI cable. So that's why I have used this one, because this HDMI cable. See, this is the general normal HDMI cable. Just simply I can plug over here, and actually this it is HDMI to VGA. So here I can connect my computer. from this my, I can connect my, this is VGA1, female VGA1. So I can connect my computer. Even we can connect the projector also. So now I'm going to connect it to projector. So for that, actually, I need to plug this one now, right? This to this, I just need to connect these two things actually. And this this one, it is to this one, Raspberry Pi. Then the other end of same thing, I have to connect it to projector, right? So that on the wall, you can see how it acts as a like computer. Then I have shown you here in Raspberry Pi 4, the type C power cable. So this is the type C power cable, right? This one is type C power cable. Okay, this is for Raspberry Pi 4. And for Raspberry Pi 3, the general one which you use in your mobile phone charger, same one. Okay, same one here, right? But this one, it is plain, all the sides, right? There is no pin. And here you can identify some pin over here. And generally, you see in your mobile phone charger, you can use generally this one only, right? So for our Raspberry Pi 3, we use this one only now, right? This can be required for Raspberry Pi 4, and I am not going to use the Raspberry Pi 4 over here. And second thing, it is that, okay, the display power, it is done. Display, yes, we have the cable now. And even we have the VGA cable to connect it to projector. Okay, display, it is done. Then now, the keyboard and mouse. So now here I'm going to connect the Logitech keyboard, and that too, it is a wireless one. Okay. So to connect wireless one, again, some USB kind of thing, it is required. So this I need to just insert here in USB, right? Automatically it will work. Otherwise, if cables are there, USB cables, somewhere I have that also. Yes, here. I'm having that one also. For this mouse, see, this it is there, right? You just connect this this wire to on your Raspberry Pi, that it will be done. But anyway, I'm having a wireless one and more flexible for me. So I'm using this wireless one only with single this USB one, wireless one, Bluetooth one. I can connect both both mouse and keyboard, both things through wireless mode. Okay, so now let's see. Now I'll be just going to connect all the things. So just give the power connection over here. I'm only here, so no one are there to pull this thing. So. Okay, just on this one, before then that, we connect this one. Okay, and just I'll be giving connections. Just I'll be giving connections over here. Okay. One by one, just I'll be showing you also. I don't know if it is visible, but just wait. Okay. So here, what I'm doing now, I'm giving all the connections. First, and just going to connect this one Raspberry Pi and HDMI cable, just plugged in. Okay, and this Bluetooth device for keyboard and mouse. Just I am keeping over here. Done. Done. Right. Then now I am connecting the power cable to power supply first. Okay. Just keep it ready. And now I am connecting this VGA cable to this one. And before that, I'll be just going to on this one now. Just on this one. Waiting for this one. Yeah. You can just see on wall now. So just like, yes, it's now correct. Okay. Then now I'm going to connect it to power connections I'm giving. Just wait. It is connected over here now. See, here it is connected now, right? Right. Now, even internet also connected here. Internet also connected here. And I can open. Now I will be connecting this even Raspberry Pi to now our class. Right. I will be going to add that also. So for that, I have to open internet. Yes, it is there. Then now. Just I'm using keyboard and mouse, everything as like a computer. You can see actually that because the intensity is very high of projector. So I have see, I mean, I thought to connect to my TV, but problem is that in my TV, HDMIs are there, but not VGA. But here I am having cable, which is HDMI to VGA. Right. For that, I'm unable to connect. Just I'm connecting to Zoom. This one, join a meeting, and our meeting ID. Please, can anyone tell me our meeting ID once? Yes, I'm having here. No issue. Okay. 9478068 68 and 5208. Okay, so connect it. Now, same thing you can see on your screen now. Where it is asking my name, Nagendra. Not robot, and just head to join.
Yes, now it is done. Want to make it co-host. Yes, sorry. Power, it is off here now. Power gone rarely, but today bad luck. It's power off, power gone actually. So let's I want to explain some. Yes, it's back, no issue. See, so here thing it is that the initiation process and all come this one our Arduino, because in Arduino simply plug and play. But here thing it is that first you need to install the OS operating system. Right. Next, after that, some upgradation, everything it is required. So for that, some little bit, what is that? Linux operating system. Linux operating system. Not like Linux. I mean, I don't know how many of you are compatible with Linux operating system, but actually, it's difficult compared with our GUI kind of graphical user interface. Everything it is graphical user interface in this operating system Windows, but it is not like that in it is not like in Windows actually. Here everything we need to do it on our with the command Windows. So actually I thought to show all those things, but just power it is gone. So, and one more thing, don't worry that sir, we don't have that idea knowledge of this one Linux operating system, but no issue at all. Just you can actually you can learn those things as we have seen in Python, because we have not stuck at just int char kind of things actually. Right, we just started doing things, then it was very easy actually. Right, okay. So same way here in Linux also, I'll let you know how to work on that and all. But it is very easy also. It is not like if you know some statements like some command commands actually. If you are just aware of those commands, then it will be lot more can do actually. Now it is boot. It is done. Boot. It is done. Okay. Yes. Now internet. It is connected. Okay. And now I can just open this one now. Here internet. Everything. It is. See in Windows here in bottom you can see everything, right? But in the Linux you can see in top this one. Just everything like Windows also just open restore. Suppose let's say if I say restore, okay. You can see everything as like computer only, right? As like computer only here. Since I need to join from fresh, actually, I have to enter the ID 947 806 8 68 68 and 5208. Right, 5208. Someone asked me that memory card bootable for no, not at all required. Actually, no need to make it bootable. Just directly you can do that. Directly you can insert your memory card in a slot and just connect it to computer and copy the OS operating system which is downloaded, pre-downloaded, and just unplug it and insert in your Raspberry Pi, then just start doing. It's that simple actually. Okay, so now here my this one, it is added now. I'm going to add this one. I'm going to make it co-host. Sir, is it co-host now? Nagender, another device, it is Nagender. Is it co-host, sir? Sir, please check once.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, thank you, sir. Thank you. Now, all you can see on your computer, see, even now, I want to just show you. See, that video also, it is coming now, like which I am taking from this one. That video also, it is actually showing on this one. See, that video, it is there on screen. Right. I'm going to share this screen here now. But before sharing screen, I just want to open this one. Yeah. It is asking me what to share. Just you see here how window it is showing over there. You can just see over here now. Okay, then just stop sharing and again share application window. Yes. Right. Now all you might be seeing that complete black screen, and that I am going to actually show you now. Sir, just make the black screen. Sir, can you make that screen as a pin? Can you pin that screen, sir?
Okay.
Oh, yes, sir.
It's not shared. Not shared the screen. Started the video.
Is it, sir? Okay, just I'll be sharing now. Yes, sir. This one I want to connect it actually. Okay, sir.
Right.
So now, just I want to show you here how to work with this environment. So just see over your on your screen now. Everything you can it can be visible like whatever there on my Raspberry Pi. So what I'm doing here, just opt some this thing sudo opt get update, suppose let's say, right, and just enter. Right, so this is the process to work with the Raspberry Pi, but it is quite simple. Things like not too many like commands, only if you are aware of only fewer commands, then yes, very good, you can do that. So now I'll be taking you to actually how to use these commands. So just write this command, right? Don't just be seeing the things. Okay, just take pen and paper and just write this command. So right, okay, to update your Raspberry Pi up to date, you have to use this one, sudo apt-get update, right? Then let's say what I want to see here now, in this let's say I want to take what all the files are there, what are the files are there in different things. Now let's say if I want to see what are the files are there, just say ls, then enter. It will be showing you what all the files actually, what all the files which are existed, desktop, downloads, right? Then what is that NotPy, sorry, what is that right, and pictures, templates, documents, hi.txt, right, music, and public videos, all the things are there. And let's say if I want to show what are the things are there inside the videos, suppose let's say what are these things are there inside the videos, so cd and videos, videos, just okay, enter it, right? Now you are there, you just gone into videos folder now. Then just now write ls means it will be showing you that like list of files or folders which are there in that particular folder, right? So videos, it is completely empty actually, nothing is there. So just come back, cd, and this one, just come back, sorry, this one, oh, actually it is came to this one, yes, okay. Now now I want to go where let's say document, suppose, okay, but here something it is difficult how to come back. One second. Yes, very good. CD, that's what I'm trying, but it was, no, it is not giving. CD dot dot, I'm still in videos only. To come back, yes, very good, that worked, thank you, happy seeing, right? So now
let's say I want to go in document, suppose. Right? Just type that and this one, you can see what is there actually. We are under documents now. And just type ls and see the list of files which are there actually. Right? In that way, we can just go and see, like we can operate with command windows and let's say I want to upgrade this one. Suppose let's say I want to upgrade this one. So opt get sudo opt get upgrade. Right? Then just you can see the process now. How it is going and all. Okay, here let's say it is asking that it will be going to use some, okay, yes, right? Then it will be taking automatically. Okay, but thing it is, I want to know you one more thing here. Sir, can't we work this with graphical user interface? Like, can't we go into our files as we go in Windows and like we are using Android devices. In Android devices also, we are very well, we can move from here and there. So is it not possible? Yes, exactly, it is possible. But thing it is that you have to aware of these little bit of these things also. Like not all, at least like let's say I have used, I was used this thing when I was there in my M.Tech in IIC Bangalore. There I have used this Linux. After that, I am not having any touch of this Linux, but there are also not more than 20 commands actually, hardly not more than 20 commands. With those 20 commands itself, I was like able to manage the things. Okay, because here in this environment, if you want to install some new software, then it won't be like in Windows that next, finish, right? Like what we do generally, next. After some time, like it will be some finish button will be there. Finish, right? So that software, it will be installed. But here it is not like this, right? Okay. So here actually thing it is that we need to like sudo install some VLC kind of. So we need to write the commands actually here. Got it or not? So that so we need to aware of those things. And that I want to tell you basically. And one more thing. Generally, to run any code, because here actually in this version of Python which is there on my Raspberry Pi, which is not compatible with tkinter actually. Tkinter, where we have used tkinter, our students login project. In students login project, we developed by tkinter one actually, right? Is it or not? Tkinter. So tkinter actually it is not there in Raspberry in the Python which I am using on my Raspberry Pi, right? So I have to update that. Yesterday actually I did a little bit and after that it was very late, so just I gone to this one. So that it is possible, then how to run the code, just see here now. So my code, it is there in documents file. Then just say ls. You can see that file which is there. So Nagender Python, that it is folder actually. So again, I want to go cd and Nagender Python. Just enter it. And you can see ls, I mean the programs which are there. Students login 1.py, Python 1. So just if I say Python, yes, python, Python. Then I need to say this one, std underscore login. Let's say complete this one. Yes, this is what the way to run the program now. Just write Python, then your Python file, Python program file, .py file, right? Because here std login 1.py is our students login Python file actually, Python program file. So just say enter here, right? Actually, so it will be showing, you can see over here, that module Teak Inter, it is not exist actually. It is saying that in the file stdlogin.py and login one, which is that Teak Inter import. The Teak Inter itself means it is showing error at the line number one itself. What is that line number one actually? Import Teak Inter import, right? So Teak Inter itself, it is not there. So that's why it is showing that error. But otherwise, you could have it will be playing that. Actually, we can see the window and we can work out here actually that it is there exactly. We can work it that we can we it's very easy that we can work with that. So that's why what I was stating in yesterday's class, instead of keeping a big computer, entire computer, you just make your own program. Let's say it might be supermarket, it might be anything as the same thing, and install the thing here, and with graphical user interface only we can start that. It is not needed that every time we need to, because we are the developers here. We need to make use of these things for better this thing. Okay, so with graphical user interface, just they can click it and they start it and they can work it on that later. Okay, so for that purpose, it need not to be purchase a complete full computer here. Just it is a pocket size one now, right? Everything it is. It's like yesterday I was surprised with 2GB one. This is not 4GB one even, right? The 2GB one, it is more like my laptop. Sometimes I was finding my laptop, it is something it is lagging behind of this pocket computer, right? I was surprised of this functionality. But thing it is that need not to be purchase a computer, need not to be purchase a, just get a single board. If even you go for third version, it will be 1800 to 2000 rupees only, not much. 2GB version, 3 model, right? Raspberry Pi 3 model. And thing it is that you'll be getting brand new monitor, which is 2700 to 800 rupees. I've checked in Amazon also. And after that, some cables, that's enough. Keyboard, mouse, 500 rupees you'll be getting hardly, right? So within less than 5,000 rupees, you can make your own a beautiful computer, up to date one, and you can start working over there, right? Okay, then one more thing. Now I want to show you here. Sharing here. I don't know whether I can play that or not. You can see the background, you can see here now, right? Suppose let's say, can you see this one? Yes, right? So programming, some problem has happened. Connectivity issue is there, that is the issue, main one. Because I have connected with same internet connection, two devices. So it's hardly taking that this one now. That is the issue. One second. Yes, in background you can see the screen. Actually, here I have opened. Yes, you can see here now, programming. Right,
what all the programmings are there. You can see this blue Java IDE, right? You can find here many more things. This Node-RED, who are going to work with this IoT, right? Node-RED, it is very useful thing actually. It's very useful thing, right? Then here Python IDE is also there. Is it or not? And even Office, you can see the Office here now. Sorry, Office, right? Entire Office, it is there. Is it or not? Entire Office, it is there, right? Then this is of my complete, this one only, I have connected to Raspberry Pi only now. This is Raspberry Pi only. I'm sharing you this screen, which is project by projector actually, right? This one, it is projector based one only, which is actually given to, which is actually shooting to my wall here. That one only, right? It is not computer. It is not any professional computer here. And graphics are there, games, like lot of games are there. So you see how the game, it was actually, I don't know whether it will be playing over there or not, because screen share this one with that. Yes, it is coming. All right. So here I can say start, then even we can play, see, right? Even games also, it will be like, okay. So many things you can do with this one. Many things, not this one. Let's say, because I am not like good player, so I'm unable to this one, the two times game, it is over. Okay. But thing it is that we can do lot many things, not only this one. We can do lot many things with this one. Lot things are possible on a small device actually, which are not even possible on your things. Like here, all like each and everything, PDF viewer, everything it is there. File manager, right? If I open the file manager. Yes, I'm waiting for the display for you. Yes, it is there. Can you see here now? It is exactly like your computer only, right? It is like exactly like your computer, desktop, documents you can open, Nagender Python, just open that we were seeing, right? So you might be getting doubt that, sir, can we open same thing we like with mouse or not? Yes, you have opened it, right? See, it is not required every time that you can do only with the command window. No, with graphical user interface also you can do that, right? That's what I'm doing now. See here, yesterday login P1. So I have opened that code here. I have opened that file here actually, right? So like each and everything you can do very well. There is no issue that you can't do. It won't be like this music file. But here it is, everything it is empty. I have not done anything much here now. Yesterday night only have did all these things. So even it is showing here, actually this is 32 GB, right? So out of that 26.5 GB and free space it is 16.2 GB now, right? It is showing here everything, okay. And it is my main intention, it is that I want to tell you one thing, that it's pretty much exactly like your computer only. It is not different than the computer. So in my view of getting a computer for our nominal usages, see where we can't use it actually, because this, it is a single chip one. So here the fan, it is not there. So it is like quite a heating. If we give, like if we run use like games and all, is it or not? So for that kind of case, we need to add some external fan over that, external some heat sink devices on that, so that it will be like pretty much good, exactly like your computer. Okay, but thing now it is that some limitation, like it will be heating, because why? Now it is not that heat actually, just I'm touching it now and I'm seeing. So that, not that much heat actually now, but thing it is that, for better usage, better this thing, we have to connect to the heatsink devices, which is there on your laptop or computer everywhere. Some external fans are there, same way. and even heatsink devices also. But other than that, everything it is same like that only. And sometimes, you know, some, let's say, some simulations are there. Like for me, NS2 simulations, I can't run that NS2 simulations on this one. You know, for that, I can't even run on my laptop also during my PhD, right? I used to use, what is that, 8 GB, 16 GB computer actually, 16 GB RAM computer. And that computer, for to run one program, it will be taking like around 24 to 28 days, right? So that huge programs may not be run here. That is the issue actually. Okay, but other way, for our case, it is we can do all the things. There is no issue at all. Okay, but thing it is that software availability for this version, like Linux things, whatever Linux things are there, most probably we can run all those Linux supports here. And but that it need to compatible with this operating system. Only that is the issue. But otherwise, you can run all the softwares over here. Okay. So again, just see here, closing window, everything, it is like same of your computer, nothing much difference. And let's say we, you people might be getting some doubts, sir. Can we play any video, YouTube, can we do that or not? Let's say we do, whether we do it or not. So just go to YouTube and start playing here. Right, internet somewhat it is low, but no issue. It's coming now. I want to play some smaller video. Okay, we can do all the things. Let's say my video only. See how I am using all my this thing. You can see here now. This is my video while teaching this one to Adobe Spark. Right? You can't. You won't be getting voice over here because I'm just. It's just screen sharing. Right? So we can play videos also. There is no issue at all. Right, because every time you see our, this one is also our video only, our class, weather monitoring station class. Right. So, so easily we can play videos also, no issue. Right? Then let's say if you want to try, like you can do, you can open very well all the things. Like it is not limited, like you can web surface, let's say UPSC, I want to open some UPSC website, UPSC. Just open, yes. So everything is possible over here. Everything is yes, sir. Will burn up. Okay. So everything is possible. Just like a computer only. Computer only. So what I want to tell you that just get your own Raspberry Pi and start doing the things. And what I have told you yesterday, like because when you do with this limited kind of thing, then you will get to know, okay, how to use this first. And second is that in like dynamic applications, in those applications with this huge cost cutting, and how can we make our own applications, okay? So that was I was telling in yesterday's class. Okay, so this is what the complete Raspberry Pi, how to interface it to the devices, like input devices and output devices.
So today we have interfaced with almost all the things, and we made a pocket size computer finally, right? But thing it only one thing it is that I couldn't show you how Python it was running, because the tkinter it is not there in my installed Python version. With that issue I couldn't do that. Otherwise with one small thing, just repeal it and I'll just wind up. Sir, two more minutes, just I'll be doing that. Repeal it. Dot it. And we can open our, very well, we can open our those programs, previous programs. Let's say my repeals. Right. So here, yes, this one. No, here help modules, it is not that issue. Tkinter, it is not installed actually. Tkinter, it is not installed. So that's why that is the issue. Happy Singh asking that. Okay, just run. Right? So you can see exactly. Right? So everything it is possible. So no need to worry about this one. Just get your own Raspberry Pi and just start working. Okay. All the things you can run over here. No issue in that. Thing it is that just you need to write Python, then your Python file name. Python, just type Python and Python file name. You can just run the code actually. Okay. Thank you all. Thank you. Next session, people they are waiting. So I'm just winding it up here. And thank you all. If you have any doubts kind of thing, and you just contact through WhatsApp or some other mode. In near future, we are making our own app, and I'll be connected through that app. Okay, thank you all. I'll be sending that app to all. Okay, thank you.